Hello and welcome to Bühler's optical sorting webinar, how to prevent, detect and eliminate foreign bodies during nut processing. In this webinar, we'll specifically focus on the different types of foreign bodies found, food industry regulations, the sources of foreign bodies, best practice solutions that are in place and processing technologies used to remove foreign bodies, and the capabilities and limitations of each. By the end of this webinar, you'll have an informed understanding of how to eliminate foreign bodies during each key stage of the nut processing line, and an in-depth knowledge on the main foreign body removal technologies used during nut processing. So, let's begin by first of all understanding what a foreign body actually is. At Bühler, we define it as something that the customer perceives as being alien to food. This could be an item which comes from the product itself, which the consumer is not expecting to eat, such as shell or hull in ready-to-eat nuts, or which comes from the field, harvest, transport, processing, or manufacturing stages. Like sticks and stones from the harvest, or metal, glass, and plastics from processing machinery or packaging materials. How do other organisations define foreign bodies? The Food and Drug Administration, the regulatory body in the USA, considers the presence of foreign bodies in food to be the adulteration of a product ingredient so that it's no longer safe to eat. And a well-known global food manufacturer considers foreign bodies to be any object or matter which may become part of the product being produced, which is not designed to be part of such product. Despite the different definitions, there are two critical points to remember. Foreign bodies are items the customer is not expecting to eat or that may be considered not safe to eat. So how are physical hazards regulated in the food industry? Firstly, it's important to remember that nut processors will be bound by different food safety regulations globally, depending on where the nuts are being produced, whether the nuts are intended for export or for local consumption only, who the nuts are being sold to. For example, food manufacturers and retailers will have strict processing guidelines and will undertake regular inspections of their suppliers. Let's look at the guidance published by the US Food and Drug Administration. Hard or sharp objects, which are 7mm to 25mm in size amongst ready-to-eat products, are considered to be high risk. For example, a piece of glass found amongst a bag of ready-to-eat nuts. Hard or sharp objects under 7mm in size in food intended for certain groups are also considered to be a high risk. For example, hard objects in baby food or food intended for children. Hard or sharp objects between 7mm and 25mm amongst products that require further preparation are considered to be a moderate risk. For example, a stone found amongst a bag of uncooked rice. Any other foreign material found amongst food is considered to be a lower risk. For example, paper or insects found amongst vegetables. So how do foreign bodies come into contact with nuts? Let's start by looking at the typical journey nuts go on before they end up on the supermarket shelves. The start of the journey is harvesting, when the nuts are picked, shaken from the trees, and plants on which they grow. At this stage, it's common for soil, grit, stones, weeds, insects, and plant material to end up amongst the harvested crop. After harvesting, they are typically loaded into trucks and transported into the pre-processing facilities. Whilst being transported, insects, rodents, animal matter, glass fragments, and items such as hair from people handling the goods could potentially come into contact with the nut product. Once the product reaches the pre-processing stage, the nuts may be hulled, shelled, and may even go through some basic cleaning to remove foreign bodies from the harvesting and transportation stages. After pre-processing, it's important to remember that in some instances, the nuts will be sold to retailers directly. Think of the in-shell peanuts that you might buy in a supermarket, and nuts that don't require any further processing. If the nuts are being sold direct to retailers, then the retailer may stipulate that more advanced removal technologies are put in place to mitigate the risk of foreign bodies being present. On the other hand, if the nuts are not sold directly to retailers, they are then typically sold in bulk to processors. This is where nuts will undergo further processing, such as roasting and flavouring, before being sold to retailers or manufacturers. There are many items which could end up with the nuts during this processing stage. These may include processing machinery parts, such as metals or plastic, items such as hair, jewellery, nails, pens, medicines from the people involved in production, personnel protective equipment, such as clothes, hairnets and gloves, sampling equipment such as swabs and sponges, fragments of packaging material, parts of utensils like brushes and tools, parts of the surrounding environment including paint, flakes, glass and wires. Once the nuts have reached the processing stage, there will be several points in the process line where foreign bodies from the field and harvest and collection and transport stages are removed. However, considering the high risk of foreign bodies coming into contact with nuts during the processing stage, it's essential that there are reliable removal technologies in place. Once the processing stage is complete, the nuts are either packaged and sold for retail or sold to manufacturers in bulk, who will use the processed nuts as ingredients in their own products. If they're being packaged and sold for retail, it's important to remember there is still some risk of foreign bodies coming into contact with the product via personnel factors and packaging fragments if the packaging has been damaged in any way. If the nuts are not sold to retailers directly from the processors, then they will typically be sold to manufacturers who will use them as ingredients in their products. During the manufacturing stage, the nuts will go through various different food processing methods, depending on whether they're being made into chocolate bars, cereal, or ice cream. As with the processing stage, there is a continued risk of processing machinery, personnel factors, and items from the surrounding environment entering the processed product. We've looked at the process line and the types of foreign bodies that come into contact with nuts during different stages. Let's now look at the measures we can put in place during each stage to minimise the risk of foreign bodies coming into contact with the nuts. Going back to the harvesting stage, to eliminate the risk of soil, grit, stones, weeds, insects and plants from coming into contact with the nuts, harvesters could consider adopting a good agricultural practice. An example of this is professional pest control or the implementation of regular cleaning and sanitisation protocols. The pre-processors could consider proven pre-cleaning technologies such as size separation, aspiration and density separation technologies, more on these processes later, to remove common foreign bodies from the harvest and transportation stages. After pre-processing, the nuts are now ready to enter the food processing stage. This could be with a processor or a manufacturer. As mentioned earlier, there should be several points for foreign bodies to be removed during this stage. These may include separation technologies such as sieves and aspiration, which remove foreign bodies such as husks by air, density separation, removing foreign bodies by their density, and magnetic separation, which remove ferrous metals such as machinery parts. The process is also likely to include optical sorting machines, which remove foreign bodies using optical properties, such as colour, near-infrared reflectance, InGaAs, or laser technologies. There may also be X-ray technologies removing foreign bodies by detecting differences in density between the good and foreign product and metal detectors. After the food processing stage, the nuts will then be transported for retail. As we mentioned, the nuts should already be packaged at this point, but retailers should inspect the integrity of a package to reduce the risk of foreign bodies coming into contact with the nuts after they've been processed. We've briefly looked at the technologies used to remove foreign bodies during a best practice nut processing line, but we now need to understand the importance of shape, size, colour, density and magnetic properties when removing foreign bodies. Foreign bodies can only be removed from the good product if any of their physical characteristics differ from those of the actual good product itself. The most common physical characteristics are shape, size, colour, density, magnetic properties, but of course there are more. Different removal and separation machines look at different properties in order to remove foreign bodies, and there is no single machine which will remove all types or eliminate them completely. That's why it's important to have a solid line of defence, a sequence of machines, throughout the entire nut processing line to minimise the risk of foreign bodies being present. It's also worth noting that there is no single machine for certain foreign body types either. For example, a destoner is not the only machine which can remove stones. Some stones can also be removed by separators, sieves, and indeed optical sorting machines too. In fact, a destoner itself will not be used to remove stones that are of a similar density to the good product, as this would result in an unprofitable loss of good product, coming back to the notion that foreign bodies can only be removed if they differ in shape, size, colour, density, and magnetic properties. This really reiterates the importance of using multiple foreign body removal machines to achieve the best possible performance. For example, in this picture, you can clearly see that the foreign body, in this instance sticks, are very different in shape to the actual good product itself. Therefore, a machine which removes and separates by shape and size would be used to remove them, preferably both. However, it would not be impossible to have sticks which are of a similar shape, size, colour and density to the product either, especially if they have gone down the process line and be chopped and roasted. In this instance, using in-gas technology, i.e. cameras operating in the near-infrared, might be the best method for detection, adding another layer of assurance. In this image, you can see that the foreign bodies are large and hard plastic pieces, which differ in size to the good product. Therefore, a machine which removes and separates by size will probably be used to remove these hard plastic pieces. However, the plastic is also a different colour to the good product, so a machine which uses optical properties, like an optical sorter, could also be used to remove them. Again, coming back to the point that there is no one-size-fits-all approach for the removal of foreign bodies. In this image, you can see that the foreign body is clear glass. Glass typically tends to have a different optical property than the actual good product itself, so a machine which uses optical properties, like an optical sorter, could also be used to remove them. And finally, you can see that the foreign body here is stones. Stones tend to be of a much higher density than good nut product, and so a machine which removes and separates by density will be used to remove these. Unless there are some stones of a similar density, again, not impossible, and machines which look at other properties should also be used to ensure that all eventualities are accounted for. To summarise, there are a vast range of removal technologies available today, but none which can remove all types nor eliminate them completely. As a result, a strong and balanced line of defence consisting of multiple complementary removal technologies is required to protect the quality and safety of the product. So now you know that foreign body removal machines typically use shape, size, colour, density, and magnetic properties to remove hazardous items. Let's take a look at the actual machines themselves. The drum magnetic separator uses magnetic properties to remove foreign bodies. As you can see in this animation, the product is fed through into the rotating drum, which also includes a static magnetic part. The good product, the product which doesn't have any magnetic properties, makes its way down into the accept stream, whereas magnetic foreign bodies, like ferrous metals, are attracted to the surface of the drum. When the drum rotates further, these magnetic particles are no longer attached to the surface and drop into a reject stream. The main benefit of the magnetic separator is that it can remove foreign bodies which contain ferrous materials, but it cannot remove non-magnetic foreign bodies like sticks, stones and glass, or indeed non-ferrous metals such as aluminium, lead and brass. Now let's move on to the separator and aspiration channel, which are typically installed as a sequential unit. The separator and aspiration channel uses size characteristics to remove foreign bodies. As you can see in the animation, the product is fed through the machine at the inlet, and the intentional vibration of the machine moves the product along the sieves. There are three sections in the machine, each of which contains mesh of varying sizes to provide a separation of coarse particles at the top, smaller ones in the middle, and fine ones at the bottom. This is achieved by varying sieve openings, which allow smaller items to gradually pass through. The coarse and fine particles are fed into separate or combined reject streams, and product in the target size range is fed into the accept stream. The accept stream then passes the aspiration system, in which an adjustable airflow is used to achieve a separation of light particles from the good product. The main benefit of the separator is that it can remove foreign bodies that are either smaller or larger than the good product itself, like sticks, wood shavings, sand, and larger stones. In addition, the aspiration system removes light particles. The main limitation with this machine is that it cannot remove foreign bodies which are of a similar size and density to the nut product, shell being a good example. Next is the destoner. A destoner uses density characteristics to remove foreign bodies from good nut product. As the animation demonstrates, the product stream is separated according to its specific gravity. This is done by the vibratory, the swinging back and forth motion of the screen, which transports product on the screen's upstream against the product flow, and by the air flowing through the product from bottom to top. This means light particles collect at the top of the product layer, and heavy particles, such as stones, move to the bottom of the screens, where they're transported upstream towards the reject stream. The main benefit of the destoner is that it can remove high-density foreign bodies, but it cannot remove foreign bodies which are of a similar density to the good nut product. In order to minimise the unintended loss of good product due to the densities of some stones and the good product overlapping, an optimal working point is needed. And finally, the optical sorter. Optical sorters use camera technology to remove foreign bodies based on colour, shape, size, and even non-visible optical properties. As the animation demonstrates, the product is fed through onto the chute and defective product and foreign bodies are detected using advanced camera technology. Ejectors then fire air at the detective defective product and foreign bodies, forcing them into the reject stream. The good product continues to run down the chute into the accept product stream. The benefit of optical sorting machines is that they can remove a range of foreign bodies because they use a number of different characteristics: colour, shape, size, and structure. However, the main limitation is that they cannot remove very high density items like large stones. Although the detection technology can detect the object, the released airflow may not be powerful enough to push a very heavy object into the reject stream. So now you have a good overview of the removal machines and the benefits and limitations of each. Let's look at how they work in practice in a typical nut processing line. Here you'll see each of the removal machines: the magnetic separator, the separator and aspiration channel, the destoner, and the optical sorter. Let's imagine that we are processing natural almonds, which contain stones from the field and harvest stage, shell from the actual product itself, glass from the transport stage, and metal from the processing stage. The natural almonds containing the foreign bodies enter the processing line and are then fed through the magnetic separator, which removes any items that have magnetic properties. Any ferrous metals present amongst the good nut product will be removed, but the stones, shell, glass, and non-ferrous metals will continue along the process line since they don't have magnetic properties, thus cannot be removed. The next removal machine they approach is the separator and aspiration channel, which removes foreign bodies that are either smaller or larger than the natural almonds. This means that small and large stones, shell, and metals should be removed, but any items of similar size to the natural almonds will still remain in the good product. For example, shells are quite often the same size as natural almonds, and also stones can be too, so these will continue down the process line. Next, moving on to the destoner. The destoner will remove foreign bodies which are of a higher density to the good nut product. At this stage, the natural almonds may still contain non-ferrous metals and stones, shell and glass, which are of a similar size to the natural almonds. During this stage of the processing line, high-density foreign bodies such as metal, glass and heavier stones such as granite and brick will be removed since, although similar in size, they are typically of a higher density than the natural almonds. By now, the natural almonds should only contain foreign bodies which are of similar size and density to the natural almonds, like larger or whole shell pieces and small, lighter stones such as limestone. The product is now fed through the optical sorter, which removes foreign bodies based on their colour, shape, size, and non-visible optical properties. So in our example, the shells will now be removed because although they may be the same colour, shape, and size of the natural almonds, they actually have different structural properties that the optical sorter can detect, enabling them to be removed. The stones, such as limestone, will also now be removed. Limestone is quite often irregular in shape and lighter in colour to the natural almonds, so can be detected. All foreign bodies should now be removed at a high level of confidence. However, remember earlier on we identified that foreign bodies can be accidentally introduced during each key stage of processing, including the food processing stage. In our example, we did not take into account that items could still make their way into the product after they've gone through the magnetic separator, the separator and aspiration channel, the destoner and the optical sorter. For example, this could happen in the case of service works carried out on a neighbouring line or in the building. As such, processors should ensure they use a removal machine, such as an optical sorter or X-ray machine, at the very end of the line as a final quality control check. Let's recap what we've learnt. A foreign body is an item that the customer is not expecting to eat or are considered unsafe to eat. The most common physical foreign bodies found in nuts are shell, sticks, stones, metal, glass, and plastics. They come into contact with nuts during different stages of processing: field and harvest, collection and transport, food processing, and retail stages. There are a number of different removal technologies that processors can use to eliminate these foreign bodies. These technologies use physical characteristics such as shape, size, colour, density, and magnetic properties to remove foreign bodies. They are magnetic separators, separators and aspiration channels, destoners, and optical sorters. A single machine will not remove all foreign bodies, so a solid line of defence, a sequence of machines, should be used throughout the entire nut processing line to minimise the risk of foreign bodies being present. Please keep in mind that no processing technology has a 100% efficiency in removing foreign bodies. Therefore, it's critical to prevent the entry of any foreign body at first hand by following good manufacturing practices and dedicated HACCP, Hazard Analysis and Critical Control Points plans. That's all for now. We hope you found this webinar useful and look forward to seeing you again at our next webinar.